Hey guys, welcome back to Nexapart Technologies. In this video, we'll be learning how to convert the KivyMD ToDo application we built into an Android APK file, all from scratch. Make sure you watch this video to the end so you don't miss any step. Let's get started. Okay guys, as you can see on my screen now, the ToDo application is running. So we are deploying this into an Android APK file. So first thing we need to do, we need to clean up our application first. Okay, so let's clean every function we don't need. As for this configuration, we don't need it. We clean this up. Then we add some other functions. Now let's copy this code. So this if application is equals to Android, from Android, this one is just for permission, to request for permission when you open the app. Okay, let's do the other things as well. Okay, let's import the module, the library for the platform. So from kivy.utils import platform, this is just for the permission. Okay, and the other thing we need to do is we need to copy this code as well for the keyboard. It's just for the keyboard, should not overlap the text field. Okay, this is what we need. And the other thing we need to do again now. Okay, so let me copy the code. Dev on start. Okay, we are going to run that in our Kivy application. So this it will be here, dev on start. So when you start the application, it will run the application to request to allow permission to our storage location. Right. Okay, the next thing for us to do is to go to our Google Colab. This is our Google Colab now. We need to install some libraries, which this is the library we need to install. I will send this file in the description. Okay, so let's install all this library. Okay. So this is the Buildozer file as well. We clone the file. It's a GitHub file. So we clone it as well. Let's run this application as well. Okay, let's wait for it to load. Let's run the application. Okay, the next thing for us to do is to change directly to the Buildozer file that was cloned. This is the Buildozer file. Okay, let's change directory. Let's run the setup to install Buildozer. Okay, and for the last one, this is what we need to do. Let's create a new folder and let's name it ToDo application. Okay, now the thing we need to do is to upload all our ToDo application into this directory we created. Okay, let's do that now. Okay, now let's upload our file. Okay, we click the directory we created, we click on the upload. Okay, these are the files I want to upload. The splash, the properties, and the KV file. So okay, these are the file I want to upload. Okay, now I already have the file. So now the next thing for us to do is let's change our directory to the ToDo app we created. Let's see cd.todo app. Okay, now my directory is properly changed to the ToDo app now. Okay, the next thing for us to do is to do our Buildozer.init. We're doing this, or we install our KivyMD 2.0.1.dev. Let's install that first. Okay. Okay, let's wait for it to load. Okay, our KivyMD 2.0.1.dev is installed successfully. Now the next thing we need to do is to build an init file for our Buildozer. So Buildozer init, we create a Buildozer.spec file for us. So let's accept yes. Okay, a Buildozer.spec file is created. Let's check our directory. You've seen Buildozer.spec. So that is where we are going. That is the main thing we need to do now. So we open our Buildozer.spec now. Okay. So we need to make some changes to it. So the name of our application, Nexapy ToDo. Okay, let's give it like this, ToDo. The package name, let's give it the same name as well, Nexapy ToDo. Okay. So the next thing we need to do is source include pattern. We are using image. Okay, so we need to uncomment this as well. Okay, let's check it. Let's check everything out we need to do so we don't make any mistake. Okay, we don't need all this. Okay, requirement. What are the requirements we need? We need the KivyMD that we installed. Okay, we need the KivyMD that we installed. Okay, let's go. Let me need to copy this. The GitHub repository for the KivyMD, we need to install that. Let's open our Buildozer.spec file again. Okay, let's go to requirement. Okay, let's paste it there. Okay, the other things we need to install are requirement for KivyMD to work properly, so you don't have any error or your application not running. So we need to install pillow. It's used for image. We need to install all this as well with it. So we need to copy it to our requirement as well. Okay, the material U color, the async KV, the async GUI, and the pillow. The pillow is used for image. So we need to copy all this one. We are using them as well. Okay, what else do we need to do? Our pre-splash. I already have the pre-splash image. It's the image that we show when we open our app. It's the image that we first show. So this is the directory is data. Let's create a new directory that will be data/pre-splash.png. Let's create a new directory. Let's name it data. Okay, let's rename this properly. Let's copy this name. Okay. Now let's copy the file inside the data. Okay, we have done that. The icon file name as well, the icon that we show for our application, that's the icon file name. So it is icon.png. Okay, let's upload new one. Okay, let's use this for the icon and let's rename it to be icon. Okay, good. So we are done with this. Let's go. Let's check what we need to do as well. Portrait. Okay, let's check properly. Okay, Android permission, the permission. So now for the Android permission, we don't really need internet because our application does not involve anything doing with internet. So we can put it there as well. Doesn't mean. So the main thing we need is write external storage and the read external storage. So it's just to read our location, our file location. Okay, Android permission. Let's paste it there. And internet, write external storage, read external storage. Let's check what else we need to do as well. All this, we don't need it. The next thing we need to do is to uncomment our Python logcat. so we can deploy properly. So in case we have any issue, we can know if the application will run successfully or we have any issue. Okay, this is it. Android lockout feature. We need to uncomment this so we can get the locks when we run our application. So okay, let's save the file. Let's save the buildozer.spec file. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is we need to copy this code as well. This is the last code we need to do. This is the last thing we need to do. We need to copy this. We need to create a manifest.hook. Okay, let's open our buildozer. Okay, let's just paste it. Let's paste it here. We can paste it anywhere. So, but let's paste it here. Okay. Let's save it. So we create let's change this one to be data. So we create a manifest.xml. Okay, so let's create a manifest.xml inside the data. Let's create a new file, manifest.xml. Okay, let's copy this code inside. It's just for the keyboard. Okay, let's change it to a txt file first, then we change it to XML later. .txt file. So we can edit it. Okay, let's save it. It's just for the keyboard to be below the target. So let's rename it to manifest.xml. Rename. XML. Okay, good. Now we are good to go. The next thing for us to do is to run our buildozer-v Android debug. So when we run this, it will wait for some time to package it into an APK file. So that's what we want to do now. So let's run our code. Now we accept permission to be yes, and we wait for it to load. Okay. It's going to ask us to accept the terms and condition. After all this, let's wait a little bit for the terms and condition so we can accept. So you just click on yes. You type in Y for yes. Okay, now let's click yes. This is what we need to do. Insert yes and click enter. Good. So this is all we need to do. Then we wait for it to run and package it into Android application for us. Then we will see the file in the bin. The APK file will be in the bin. So when you check it, you'll see the APK file and you'll be able to install it. So let's wait for it. Okay, as you can see now, we have successfully packaged it into our Android APK file. As you can see in my bin directory, this is the APK file. Now I just have to download it to my device and then install it into my Android phone. So congratulations to everyone. We were able to package our KivyMD into an Android APK file. So thank you for watching my video, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you encounter any error, please comment below. So thank you for watching my video. If you find this video helpful, click on the like button.